in that standard medical world, further workup equates to what? A stress test. And again, a third of positive stress tests are wrong, are false positives. And what happens if you've got a false positive? Just like a true positive, you go to the cath lab. What happens in the cath lab? It's PC, which stands for percutaneous, or through the skin, or invasive angiography. You get a needle, it's stuck into the groin, the catheter is fed up to the heart, and then we start using dye and taking pictures. As you see, there's a little bit of plaque there, some there. So these pictures start to look very definitive, don't they? Yep, but that quote definitive look can be very deceptive. We think we see plaque. You ever heard the question, if you're a hammer, everything looks like a nail? You know how to do a stent, that really looks like a place that needs a stent, right? Again, when you start following these people on a long-term basis and you randomize it and you put a stent in some of these people and you don't put a stent in others, no difference in heart attack. How about a little bit of history? The first angiogram was done by a fellow named Mason Soames. I think it was the Mayo Clinic, could have been Cleveland. It was in 1958 and it was an accident. It was a mistake. He was doing pediatric aortograms, you know, the aortas. And he was looking at connective tissue diseases and whether kids had problems with their aorta. He went a little bit too high, catheter dye, into the arteries for the heart, which come off at the very beginning of the aorta, inside the aortic valve leaves, in fact. Well, patient's heart stopped. And these are kids again. You would think a bad day for the patient and a bad day for the doc, but the doc was just very excited. They were able to do some things and get the heart back. So the patient really didn't know that much different. And here's what happened. He saw these amazing images. And that, again, you get back to that thing of deceptive, exciting images, deceptive, definitive images. So he saw that, and that led to this whole, it's an industry now, getting these types of images, doing PC angiograms, the cath labs. If we were to take cath labs and stents back to where they've been proven, we would wipe out a huge section of the medical industrial complex. It would disemploy tens of thousands of cardiologists and close thousands of cardiology clinics and even hospitals. So these appear definitive, but definitive nature is deceptive. These require a visit to the cath lab. There's significant irradiation. You know, you think there's radiation with a chest x-ray or a calcium score. These have huge radiation. And what exactly do they really tell us? And what I mean by that is what action comes from this, whether or not to do a stent or a bypass? And again, do those really appear to work? So all of this is based on an assumption that a plaque is, quote, vulnerable, end quote, a specific individual plaque. Now, what the science would actually indicate is that plaque is more of a systemic issue, and whether or not you're laying down plaque is more of a systemic activity. In other words, you have inflammation. Inflammation doesn't happen in just one area of one artery. It happens the entire arterial bed at once. And you, both of you probably already know, by far the number one cause of cardiovascular inflammation or vulnerable plaques is prediabetes. That prediabetes is usually driven by aging, insulin resistance. And that's why we've always thought, you know what, you get to your 60s and you might have a heart attack. There's no way to predict. Now we know, yes, there are ways to predict. So I'd like to talk with you a minute about the webinar. People don't understand what the webinar is. It's actually a great way to get some access to healthcare that you're just not going to get any other way. You actually get the lab tests yourself for at a local lab, a Quest lab near you, for the inflammation panel and the OGTT and the insulin survey. These are things, inflammation and prediabetes, that your doctor just does not know about. And here's the thing. Harvard Health and many others have said, look, sudden death is not always so sudden. the Hollywood picture that it's a bolt out of the blue is not realistic. It's more like real lightning, preceded by clouds, wind, and rain. Stop that metabolic storm before the lightning strikes. And here's where that metabolic storm comes from. It's inflammation, and it has to do usually with prediabetes. So again, we actually get labs, we go over them in the webinar, and then you can start finding out how you can prevent that heart attack others said that you couldn't even predict. We can show you how. Thanks.